So, all right, let's just talk about it. Anthropic dropped Claude Skills, and honestly, it's one of those launches that kind of sneaks up on you. If you've been hanging around the agent scene, you know everyone's got opinions. Some folks are already saying this is bigger than those fancy MCP servers, maybe even the start of real continual learning for AI agents. I'll be honest, the minute I saw the headline, my first thought was, okay, is this actually going to change my solo dev life? Or is it just another shiny workflow tool? Just real quick, I'm Daniel. Been living in the iOS trenches for, what, 8 years now? Started off freelancing, working with clients, figuring out what actually works and what just burns you out. But after Dub Dub 25, I kind of flipped the switch and went all in on solo dev life. Since then, I've shipped a bunch of my own apps, started putting everything out there in public, and honestly, these days, pretty much all my energy is going into Crafters Lab. And yeah, it isn't just another tutorial site or another AI clone farm. This is my actual home base for solo devs who treat AI like a real teammate, not just a vending machine. And yeah, I'm in it literally every day, building, tweaking, breaking stuff, just seeing what sticks, you know? And yeah, if you're part of the Patreon crew, huge thanks. And heads up, everything's moving over to crafterslab.dev. And honestly, if you want to get in as an early member and lock in your price, now's kind of the sweet spot. So here's the deal. Skills are basically Claude's answer to custom onboarding and repeatable expertise. Instead of dumping everything into a prompt, now you can actually package up a skill, a little folder with a skill.md and a set of files, and hand it to your agent like, hey, next time you need to do X, do it this way. Anthropic frames it as onboarding material, but honestly, it's more like a real documented playbook for your AI. You give it steps, resources, even sample workflows, and suddenly your agent isn't just pretending to know what your weird build process or how you handle code reviews. It's actually following the same SOPs you'd give a junior dev, and it's all defined in Markdown, not some magic API, just good old docs. Now, at first glance, it kind of sounds like what we were already doing with MCP servers or subagents, but here's where it gets interesting. With skills, you're not stuffing the whole kitchen sink into the context window up front. Instead, you start with just a description, a couple hundred tokens, and then Claude pulls in only what it needs, as it needs it. Progressive disclosure, like it actually skims the table of contents, then loads the right chapter, then the appendix. It feels organized in a way that most agent tools just aren't. And for me, that's a relief because, let's be real, half the struggle of building with AI isn't getting it to spit out code, it's getting it to remember how you want things done and not burn your whole context window trying. So I poked through some of Anthropic's own examples. They're using skills internally for stuff like file creation. It's literally just a skill.md, some Python helpers. And suddenly Claude knows how to scaffold a new file, edit existing code, the whole flow. No more guessing, no more hoping the agent picks up on it. It's all spelled out. That's the vibe. Skills are explicit, repeatable, and this is the kicker. You can reuse them everywhere. Claude apps, Claude code, even API calls. It's composable, and honestly, if you've been waiting for something a little less hacky than custom commands, this feels like the next step. So let's get into the nitty-gritty. Why does any of this matter if you're building solo or you're already juggling a bunch of MCP servers and custom commands? Here's the core thing. Skills finally give you a way to modularize your agent's brain, but without the context window bloat that's always been the Achilles heel of these setups. With MCPS, every time you load a new tool, it gets dumped straight into the session. Before you know it, 16% of your context is gone, and you're not even coding yet. Subagents? Useful, but they work in isolation, they don't share context. And you only get the final answer, none of the reasoning. It's like asking a friend to debug something for you, and all they give you is a one line works now at the end. But with skills, there's this progressive layering. The agent only loads what it needs when it needs it. If a skill's not relevant, it just gets skipped. If you ask for a code review and you've built a review skill, Claude can actually follow your checklist, reference your company guidelines, maybe even look up internal APIs you want enforced. And the really wild part, you can compose skills out of other skills. Subagents, MCP servers, they all play together, but you stay in control of what context gets loaded and when. And, you know, for solo devs, that's kind of a superpower, because instead of re-explaining your coding rituals or hoping Claude remembers your Firebase setup, you can just build a skill for it. Need to onboard yourself to a new code base after 2 months away? Skill. Want your AI to follow your code review standards, not some generic checklist? Skill. Want to teach Claude how you like your SwiftLint rules or how you do accessibility checks in Swift UI? Yep. Skill. Suddenly, your agent isn't just a slot machine for code gen. It's running your actual playbook your way. And crucially, it's not blowing up your session with 30,000 tokens of fluff. It's just loading the chapter it needs. All right, so this is the part that actually got me thinking about using skills in my own setup. When do you reach for them and what do they look like in practice? If for me, the light bulb moment was realizing that skills let you capture how we do things here, even if we is just me. Maybe I want to document a code review process or how I onboard a new module or even a tricky build script. With skills, I can write a markdown guide, wrap up any scripts or helpers I want Claude to use, and the agent can actually follow my process step by step. And here's the fun part. Claude's already got a skill creator. I literally asked it, can you make a skill that does code review? And boom, it spun up a skill.md, some usage examples, the works. You can use these across Claude apps, Claude code, anywhere you need. You can even share them. Honestly, that's where I see this going. Swap skills with your indie friends, build up a little library of personal playbooks. But let's keep it real. This isn't magic. You still have to be clear about what you want. The better you spell out your expectations in the skill.md, with input slash output formats, examples, even edge cases, the smarter your agent gets. And just like with Claude.md or rules.md, it's something you'll want to tweak as you go. Treat it like a living doc, not homework. The real unlock is reusability. Once you've built a code review skill, you can use it in every new repo. If you've got a skill for handling App Store screenshots, or running a specific linter, or managing your localizations, you're never starting from scratch. You're building up a real evolving toolkit, and your agent is finally getting smarter with you, not just for you. Here's where I land after a week messing around with skills. It's the first time since maybe custom slash commands that I felt like I could actually teach an agent to work my way, not just do what I say, but follow the rituals, the checklists, the weird little details that make my workflow mine. And, you know, there's a bigger story here. As solo devs, we don't have a team to back us up or a big engineering playbook. Our way of doing things lives in our head in sticky notes, or if you're me, half-finished Notion docs. But now for the first time, we can actually encode those rituals into the agent. It's like onboarding your past self, your future self, and your AI teammate all at once. The best part, you're not locked in. Skills are just folders, markdown, some helpers. You can tweak, remix, share, and most importantly, has he build up a real foundation that follows you from project to project, tool to tool, Claude, apps, API, whatever. It finally feels modular. And as someone who's always been a little nervous about vendor lock-in, the fact that skills are this portable, that's huge. Even if the agent world keeps shifting, your workflows aren't tied to one UI or one pricing scheme or one context window. It's your toolkit on your terms. All right, so yeah, if you're still here, seriously, you are a legend. I mean, I know these videos can get kind of long and deep, so I honestly appreciate you sticking around all the way to the end. If anything I rambled about actually resonates, or you just want to see how far you can take this whole solo dev plus AI thing, go check out crafterslab.dev. It's packed with everything I wish I'd had back when I started. No joke. There's a Discord if you want to stay accountable or just hang out and see clear into the fog with some other indie devs. There's a whole set of resources in the pipeline. App blueprints, Figma foundations, all the growth insight stuff I wish I could have Googled back in the day. And, you know, the real magic is in the Notion workspace. You've got team spaces for days. There's the playbook, which is basically my live command center where I plan out every app, write the docs, and honestly, just show what's working and what's flopping. Then there's Swift Brain. That's my own deep dive. Swift and Swift UI library, the kind of stuff I literally use to fine-tune and train my AI agents, whether it's Claude, Cursor, or Codex. And the newest addition, Ops Lab, is where I'm building and sharing my actual AI agent systems, the Notion automations, the workflows, all the setups that keep my solo dev universe humming. Put all of that together, and you get what I call Crafter OS. It's kind of this evolving operating system for solo developers who are treating AI like an actual teammate, not just a magic button you hit when you're desperate. I'm still refining it, still breaking stuff and putting it back together, but honestly, that's the whole point. If you want to get in as an early member and lock in your price, right now is honestly the best time. The door is wide open, and yeah, I'd love to see you there. So, you know, thanks again for hanging out, for being part of this weird little corner of indie iOS and AI. And if you ever want to swap stories, trade workflows, or just say, hey, my DMs are open. Until next time, keep building. Keep tinkering, and don't let the hype distract you from actually shipping what's yours. Catch you later. Peace.